Hi everyone, welcome to Color Tunes with Sampada and Purvi. Today we learn how to give textures of fur using watercolors. So let's get started. Here we're using ochre yellow. This is going to be a base coat. So we'll start marking the directions of the fur. Here I'm painting those parts where I want the darker shade. And then we'll smudge everything using water. So this will leave suggestions of dark and light tones. Our layer has dried. Now we'll take a mixture of ochre yellow and burnt sienna or brown. Here I'm using a thin brush to render these thin lines. So using a thin brush, just go on giving strokes like these. Okay, so let me just speed up things for you. Now you can see that I'm making these S-shaped lines. This will give our fur a wavy look and also make it look lively. So here again I'm applying ochre yellow wherever I want depth or darker tones. So we've let it dry. Now I'll go ahead with burnt sienna or brown. So just go on giving thin strokes. Watercolors fade away or look paler when they dry. That's because you've used more water and less of paint. So here, to make our work look more lively, we'll go with the layer technique where we move from lighter tones to darker tones. So here you can see I'm making thin strokes wherever I want depth. Again, I'm using the same thin round brush. This requires a little bit of patience, but the outcome turns out to be awesome. So here, as you can see, I'm maintaining the light and dark tones. Just be careful that you don't cover the previous layer. That's the first layer what we did. Make sure you don't just go in one direction since it's fur. So we've not let it dry completely. Here we've mixed brown with Prussian blue and a hint of black. Now we'll apply this wherever we want it to be darker. So here just make sure that we don't completely cover up our previous layers. The best part about watercolors is that it uses layer technique. So it's really important that you keep all your layers visible. And this also, you know, has an effect on our overall painting. So make sure that you don't cover the layers completely. it's really important to use a thin brush while doing furs, as this gives a nice effect. And now, since our previous layers were semi-dry, this layer will kind of merge with the previous layer, giving it a nice shade. Okay, let me just speed up things. So, you can use this technique to paint animals or some specific kind of clothing, or you know, even grass as well. So, let us know if you have some other ideas in the comment section. Okay, so here I've used Prussian blue with black. So we'll use this where we want more of depth. That's burnt sienna, since I want a light shade there. I'll merge it with ochre yellow. Here also I've applied burnt sienna and ochre yellow. Let's preview our three major layers. Here we go. Please like, share, and subscribe if you liked our video. Thanks for watching.